discuss the necessity of the radius of gyration. That means the first point to discuss is physical significance. Necessity means use means physical significance of radius of gyration. This is to be discussed. Define the calico it is the distance between the center of mass of the body and axis of rotation. It is a perpendicular distance. Okay? It is generated by J and measured in meter. On which factor it depends on? So it depends on I and M. More it depends on distribution of mass. More it depends on distribution of mass. And the value of k is equal to under root of I divided by n. It does not depend on. Does not depend on what? Does not depend on, you can say omega, alpha. These are the things in which it does not depend on. Can you locate some similarity between center of mass and radius of gyration? Yes, we can. There is the distance between the center of mass and the axis of rotation. The perpendicular distance is called as the radius of gyration. If suppose the radius of gyration is more, that means from the axis of rotation, the center of mass is very far away, right? And if suppose the radius of gyration is less, that means from the axis of rotation, the center of mass is very much nearer. Okay, so this k value defines the distribution of mass. Can you infer with the uniform ring and uniform disk which have the same radius? So what you can we can see, if suppose they have the same radius of gyration. Okay, same radius of gyration. So we can see what you can infer if the ring and the uniform disk have the same radius of gyration. So this is what a ring. This is what a ring shape, and this is what a disk shape, and they are having the same radius of gyration. K is what shape? So what is meant? K of ring, it is equal to K of disk. So mass, there is no relation of the mass, so we'll consider this is what ring. So this is equal to I, it is equal to mr square, and here the value of I, it is equal to m r square divided by 2. Okay, so k does not depend on m, so we will consider that they are having the same mass m, and the radius of the ring is suppose rr, the radius of the disk is suppose rd. So the value of k here, k of r, it is equal to r only, rr, right? The radius of the ring. While what is the value of k of disk? K of disk is equal to r of disk divided by root 2. K of disk is equal to r of disk divided by root 2. Now what is given here? Kr, it is equal to kd. That means kr is what, rr, it is equal to kd. Kd means rd divided by root 2. So what we can say, this is the relation that the radius of the ring should be equal to radius of the disk divided by root 2. Or you can say radius of the disk is equal to root 2 times radius of the ring. So suppose these two statements are satisfied. These two statements are satisfied. That means the radius of gyration of the ring and disk will be same. Okay. So you can take a screenshot and I will move to the next question. Okay, so I'm moving to the next question.